Championship Wrestling, bringing you great wrestling action, sanctioned by the NWA, National Wrestling Alliance.
Welcome to World Championship Wrestling. I'm David Crockett.
And Tony, it's good to be back because we've got one exciting program for him.
David, it's really good to have you back. You know, today, Nature Boy Ric Flair, the World Heavyweight Champion, will show everybody that brand new belt that he has, that $35,000 trophy that is his new NWA World Heavyweight title belt. Arn Anderson, who's a World Television Champion, will defend that title right here today on TV. And some very exciting news about the tournament, the tag team tournament for the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup to come today on the program, plus, David, all the stars in the world of wrestling.
That's right, but there's a saying, rock and roll is here to stay. The Rock and Roll Express is right here. Come on in, guys.
Here they are, former World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express. Last week on this program, presented Betty Lou Dusty Rhodes, and I can understand why you guys are smiling.
You know, Tony, Jimmy Cornette has always sticking his nose in the Rock and Roll Express's business. And thanks to Dusty Rhodes, you know, he loaned us Betty Lou. And Betty Lou, Jimmy Cornette, you're going to be 80 feet up in the air, and there ain't nothing you can do to help your Midnight Express.
That's right, Tony. There's nothing that Jimmy Cornette's going to be able to do. But, you know, justice has got to be done. You know, they fined Jimmy Cornette $5,000, but, you know, Jimmy Cornette, that's just not enough for us. So, baby, you be looking, and you be looking hard, because, baby, rock and roll is going to get you. Woo!
Sooner or later.
All right, the Rock and Roll Express, let's go to the ring. It's complete obliteration of Carl Stiles and his partner Bill Mosby.
Drops that tremendous elbow across his chest. They'll take him now, pick him up. Watch out. He's up on that top rope. Flies off. Goes down for the pin. And he's got him. Your winner. The Road Warriors with Paul Ellering.
And here they are, quick over that win, Hawk Animal and Precious Paul Ellering.
Hey, Tony Schiavone, the heat's on high. The water's not boiling yet. It's simmering. But when it gets done boiling, someone ain't gonna be in this country no more. We're gonna be in this country. We're not going anywhere. But when it finally does boil, you can be bit sure of one thing, that the Russians are no longer gonna be in this country, because we're the ones that are gonna kick them out.
No, stop, Tony Schiavone. I hope you're watching that Nikita Koloff that would have sent you all the way back to Moscow. We're gonna get you, we're gonna kick your butt. And one thing, we're from this stinking country. When you lose, it's going to be in a contract. You're going back to stinking Moscow.
You know, Tony Schiavone, I heard the rock and roll out here, and it sounds like the Midnight Express is a wanted team. Well, they're not only wanted by the rock and roll, they're wanted by the Legion of Doom, because there's a lot of money involved in those titles, Midnight Express. And after all, there are victories that cost more than defeat, and your victory over the rock and roll may just cost you a match with the Legion of Doom. In the lay world, it's called an anomaly. In the Legion of Doom's world, it's called despair on your part.
Back right after this timeout.
In the ring, Tully Blanchard and J.J. Dillon up against Mike Jackson. Tony, you look at this combination of J.J. Dillon and Tully Blanchard. They've already issued a warning to Dusty Rhodes, and now understand it's two more weeks.
That's what I understand, David. You know, Tully came out weeks ago and said, I'm giving you 6 weeks, Dusty. And JJ said, no, it's 4 weeks. So now it's down to two, according to the plan by James J. Dillon. Administrative director, as he likes to call himself.
That is correct. But that's going to be some job for Tully Blanchard to go up against the American Dream and take the championship away.
Think about this. Dusty Rhodes, a national heavyweight champion. Before that, he was a world television champion.
That's correct.
Who beat him for that title?
That's nobody. Right. Yeah, nobody.
They had to go and take it away from him. So the fact that Tully says he's going to win the national heavyweight title. Maybe a lot of talk.
But you never know. With J.J. Dillon around. Good takedown by Jackson. Another good takedown. Tully, good defense. Now he backs up. All right, J.J. probably saw something there. Maybe saw a weakness.
Oh, that's what he said.
You're always wrestling two people when you have Tully Blanchard and JJ by ringside.
Now the fans chanting Dusty.
Tully's a little bit more cautious right now. Jackson goes in.
Tell you what, Tully, one of his strong points is his speed, and Mike Jackson just matching him speed for speed in this one.
I tell it, got him, tripped him. You've got to expect that if you're going to wrestle Tully Blanchard. He stretches every rule in the book. All right, now here he goes. Jackson's losing control. And that's exactly what J.J. and Tully wanted to do.
Blanchard down the left of your screen just smiling, knowing exactly what he's doing.
He knows he's got him. When you lose control, Tully will eat you up. Fans now shouting, we want Dusty. Catching with a hard right hand right in the face.
Tully Blanchard telling the referee to watch his tights, and then when the referee walked around, it was curtains for Jackson. Can't turn your back on Blanchard, look at there.
Throws him out. Now at this point, you've got to watch JJ. You just can't trust him. He's just standing there, waiting. Tully just pacing around.
Boy, Jackson really having a tough time getting up.
Oh, you look at JJ, he just wants to do it. He wants to kick him. Good one. Jackson goes over. He's got him. Tully catches him again. Right in the head.
Not a bad move by Jackson. Really all he could do, too. And Blanchard was ready for it.
Here he goes, whips him across. High back. Caught him right on the side.
You're right, Dave. It's a backdrop, but he landed it right on the hip that time.
Probably put a knee in the back. Snapmare takes him over. Try to hold him down.
Notice how the fans are really getting under Blanchard's skin.
Yes,
he really
they are.
Gets upset.
Every time they start chanting, we want Dusty. You can see Tully, he'll turn and just glare at him. Elbows by Jackson. Trying to take your effect on Tully. Just about there. One more, he's loose. Nice tackle. Tully. Caught that leg, pitched him out.
Back in there. Jackson really hit hard, and there you see him. Well, Blanchard gonna go get him.
Throws him back in. He goes up on that top rope, comes off. Fist right in the back of the neck. He goes over, starts it, puts a knee into him. Fist by Jackson. Another fist in the midsection. Now to the head. Sully catches him. Snap air. Holds him down now. Jackson comes out of it.
Blanchard is so conditioned. He's such a fine athlete. That a match like this, the pace of the match has really
JJ.
Been, oh, look at him, been furious. But he is in perfect condition.
Do you wonder, you think about Dusty Rhodes and you think about Tully Blanchard. Tully's saying that he's going to take the championship away from Dusty in 2 weeks. Good move by Jackson. Tully moves out of the way. Now Tully catches him with the elbow in the back.
Now, once
rolls
again,
him over.
Oh, he too close, David. Now the arm, as you can tell, in the rope. Jackson keeps coming back.
Good move. Now Tully goes out of the ropes. Falls through.
Okay, got a clean break from Jackson.
Oh, right on the chin.
That was right in the teeth.
Now Mr. Blanchard starts to pound away on him. Takes Jackson. Here he goes, whips him across. Fist right in the midsection. Picks him up now. Here he goes. Head slingshot. Suplex. Powers him over. Rolls over. Hooks the leg. And has him down for the pin.
Once again, another win for Tully Blanchard Enterprises. Okay, we're back with you on World Championship Wrestling. And like promised, here he is, the heavyweight champion of the world, Nature Boy Ric Flair.
Tony Schiavone, how about a moment of silence for the best-looking man on the face of this earth? You know, when I tell my pals, Rick and Keith Michaels, that I want to be styling and profiling on Jim Crockett's television show, because Ted Turner is sitting upstairs in his office and wants a real dude out here on the big camera, then Michaels of Kansas City puts it together. So bring the camera in one time. You like it? From the lizard shoes, huh? About $700 to the Rolex watch to the biggest diamonds my fear can hold. You are looking at pure class. But wait just one moment. You see, when your name is Ric Flair, and you represent the National Wrestling Alliance, and you just happen to work for Jim Crockett Promotions, then every once in a while, come on over here, David, the Crocketts dig down in their pockets to show some appreciation for what a real champion should be toting around. And you see, the whole country's heard about it. Now they're gonna have a chance to see it. And I'm talking about $40,000. A 24 karat gold, silver, diamonds, and rubies with my name written on the front of it. That's right, solid gold. The World Heavyweight Championship belt, worn, owned, operated, and manipulated by yours truly. The World's Heavyweight Wrestling Champion. So you see, ladies and gentlemen, whether you like it or not, I'm custom made. Whether you like it or not, I'm your world champion. And you know, you hear so much now around the world about everybody wanting to be the world champion that I just like to take a time out of my schedule to come out here periodically and show y'all what the world champion's all about. Ronnie Garvin, Dusty Rhodes, Magnum TA, Bob Armstrong, Tommy Rich, Wahoo McDaniels, doesn't make any difference. To be the man, Daddy, you gotta beat the man. And whether you like it or not, you know, the only difference between me and the guy in the red cape is I don't need a phone booth to bring my action in. You understand what I'm telling you? I'm the best there is. Woo! I'm the world's heavyweight wrestling champion.
Woo! He certainly is.
Let's see you bring somebody out here to follow that stuff, brother. Woo!
Let's go to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, in the ring now, Paul Jones and his man, Baron Von Raschke. They'll take on Rocky King. Tony, we just saw the man.
That was magnificent, wasn't it? That belt?
It really is. Like him or not, you have to respect him. He is the world heavyweight champion. That means he's the very best in the world. Ric Flair, the man in the ring. He is a machine. Baron Von Raschke, managed by Paul Jones. Paul Jones has so many strong, ruthless wrestlers. He has the monster, the barbarian, T-Jo Khan, and Baron Von Raschke. Watch this man. He is vicious. He has that claw. There he pulls the hair. Jones, very calm. Rocky King turns up. Here's the elbow. Actually catches him with the fist, the back of the neck now. Flips him across. King jumps over. Good. Tried to drop kick. Pushed him out of the way. Stomps him right in the chest. There's that headlock. What's he going to do?
That was right in the throat. Right in the throat of Rocky King. Doesn't matter how big you are, David. A blow to the throat will certainly knock you down.
Now he takes that knee. Puts it right in the midsection. Knocks the wind out. Going for the face. Look at him. Remember, his favorite hold is that claw. King trying to fight back. Snapmare by the Baron. Picks him up for this. He's going to try to slam him. He puts a knee in the chest. Holds him down. Now pulls him up by the hair, Tony.
Paul Jones, very confident at ringside. Look how the Baron looks at him, and Paul is really doing a lot of coaching right at ringside.
Tony, if you notice, the Baron has stayed mostly with the upper part. I'm just talking from the neck up.
That's right.
He's trying to set him up for that claw. Here he goes again, whips him across.
There's the foot.
He walks around. He's got the claw up. He gets ready. He has it. Squeezing tighter and tighter. Rocky King finally gives up. Baron won't release it.
touch that dial. Don't touch that dial because you're at the right place. This is the National Wrestling Alliance. This is Jim Crockett Promotions. And I am gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. And, of course, Precious by my side. You know, as you see here, the great studio is empty. There's not a person in sight. Because I tell you what, we were a little surprised when our limo got here. And a bunch of heathens just started attacking the car, looking at us and screaming and yelling. But, you know, we should get used to that because, after all, it happens all the time. It happens all the time because, ladies and gentlemen, you are looking at the greatest wrestler in the world, and by the way, it's not my fault. Not only that, you're looking at the greatest wrestler in the world. I don't eat red meat, I don't eat salt and sugar, and my hair's insured by the Lords of London, because I got the finest head of hair, too. Now, there's a couple of reasons why I'm here, and I'm not going to let it all out right now. I think I hear some fans trying to scrimmage through to the back. Keep them people out of here. We don't want nobody bothering us because we're different. We're not the same as everybody else. I'm not going to get on here and wrestle on TV because I really don't feel like it. Not only because of that, because I really don't feel like there's anybody here that can beat me.
I don't think so either, Jimmy. You know, I think you got it down.
I'm so happy, you know, I can dance out of my tennis shoes because, I mean, it's not every day, you know, a person can strut around the country like I do. I can go all over the country. It don't matter where it's at. And I have confidence because I know that I'm the greatest athlete in the world and nobody could beat me.
That's right.
Now, I know that means that Maggot T.A., or whatever his name is, he's included,
that's
right?
It.
That guy kind of reminds me of a lemming. Spray the air for him. And another guy, Dusty Rhodes. Now, there's a guy that's obviously eating too much red meat, salt, sugar, and all the other things that are bad for you. Well, it's going to take a guy like me maybe to teach that boy some manners.
That's it.
You know, I've been all around the country teaching people manners. I teach manners so good, it's just unbelievable. And by the way, my mouth is getting a little dry, and I think I might need a little kiss. Hold on just a second. I'm going to have a little kiss, and I'll be right back. Oh, yeah. You know, it takes that kind of thing. I mean, that's why I'm the greatest wrestler in the world. She takes care of me. She makes sure I'm in a good mood, and she makes sure I look finer than anybody in the world. And I think that was a good suggestion. I think you and I should probably...
I think we should get out of here.
You want to go?
Jimmy, let's go. I got something to tell you anyways. Let's go.
Well, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Precious, David.
That's right, and they are something. You know, he talks a lot, but he's a good wrestler, too.
He really is. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Precious with us on World Championship Wrestling. Let's go to the ring.
In the ring, Tejo Khan against George South. Khan's manager, Paul Jones, again.
Where does he get these guys? I mean, he
must
go
to
the most remote points in the country or in the world and pluck these men out.
He gets men that no one else can control. No one. Baron Von Raschke. Here you see Tejo Khan. He has the Barbarian. And what a monster that man is. Look at Khan. Look at him driving those knees in the south. Takes him now. Throws him out. Grabs him by the hair. Fist right between the shoulder blades. South trying to fight back, but Khan just stays with him. Has him in the ropes. There you see Jones. He's shouting instructions to him.
Warnings for Pee Wee Anderson. Had him right across the ropes that time.
Look at those massive arms of Khan. Goes down for that pin. Doesn't hook the leg. Khan picks him up. What's he going to do? His elbow right in the chest. Starts to choke. Again, takes him down for that choke. Self now trying to fight back. Just can't do it, though. Look at Khan. He's just too powerful. Rams that head right in the turnbuckle. Jones is very happy about that.
He should be. This guy is really a fine athlete.
Chops to the chest. Here Jones shouting knee. That's exactly what Khan does. Puts him across. Picks him up. Power slam. Look at this man.
Jones has to muscle him off the man.
the wild man from Singapore, Tejo Khan. Back with you now, World Championship Wrestling. We heard and saw Tully Blanchard talk about 2 weeks now, at least by our calculation, supposedly he would get this national heavyweight title. But you see who still has the title, Dusty Rhodes and Baby Doll.
You know, Tony, it's a big exciting time for wrestling throughout this country. Like Ric Flair or not, respect Ric Flair or not, you got to understand that there's one world's heavyweight champion. That gold you seen laid out on this table right here designates it so. It makes it so. His matches throughout this country, night after night, make it so. His hour draw, his battles with Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, make it so. Nobody can go on television anywhere in the country and give somebody a belt and say, okay, Jack, you're now the world's heavyweight champion. That ain't right. This is the National Wrestling Alliance. Years and years of competition throughout this country has made it so. You understand what I'm saying? Tully Blanchard, give me 2 weeks now, Doc. 2 weeks. He gonna take my national title from him in 2 weeks because he says he's making it so. You understand? And then I want to say one thing. Baby Doll, this morning, we've been reading 2,000 letters to Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. And the brothers, listen, y'all got to understand out there. I want all my brothers to understand. You know what I'm talking about. You understand? They writing to me, say, Dusty Rhodes, you bad, brother. See, they got to understand it's all H. You got an H, you got a D in it, you got an E, you got S, you see. They spell it R-O-S-E, you understand? Dusty Rhodes, that's fine with me. You know, I've been to Hollywood this week. I've been out to Hollywood. Me and Jim McMahon were doing a commercial for some sunglasses, you understand? Of course, they chose me over him. I don't go to Michael's in Kansas City. You understand? Because it just ain't my cup of tea. Nature Boy Ric Flair. But I've been to Hollywood looking for my stuff. You understand? I found my stuff in Hollywood. Yeah. Baby Doll, I want the camera to get a shot right here. This here is what Mother Nature gave the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. And I'm going to tell you what, it's good and it's a lot of it. And I love it, Jack. It's going to be right.
Let's go to the ring. The American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
Here's Ron ring. Garvin.
Huh.
I don't know how to...
He left you speechless.
Yeah, he really did.
The hands of stone. Watch Garvin. When he comes in that ring, he is all business. He's not flashy. He comes in there and he starts to pound away. Watch him. He's a smart wrestler. He can fight, he can wrestle.
Now look at Bob Owens.
Look at Garvin.
How many times have we seen somebody try to tow it out with Ron Garvin and just back up and back up and back up?
And he lives whelps all over him. Oh. He knows. He loves to make a man suffer. Uh-oh. Here he comes. Races. And gets down the back. If you won't fight him, he'll destroy you. Now watch him. Watch him wrestle now. Watch him. Look at him control the man. Sets him up. Exactly the way he wants him. When Garvin says he has a man's number, he has their number.
And there's proof right there. It doesn't matter how big you are. He can knock you right flat on the canvas any moment of the match.
Just ask the World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair.
about the Hands of Stone. Look at him now. He's going to tie him up like a pretzel. What do?
I guess you close your eyes and hope the pain will pass.
Oh, it's... He is caught. Now Garvin says, come on, fight. Come on, fight me. I won't torture you if you fight me.
Nothing much a man can do to fight Ron Garvin in that position.
Now Garvin bends the arms back a little bit more.
He'll try to touch the elbows together behind his back.
He's going, let's see if we can twist his neck around like an owl. And slap him right. Look at, oh, right in the face. Come on, fight me. Putting whelps all over him. I think, Mr. Owens, you made a mistake. I know you made a mistake. Look at Garvin. Twists the arm now. Kicks him right in the chest. Has him. Picks him up, suplex, hard down on the mat. Comes over. Oh! Puts all of his weight right on his stomach. Stomps him in the head. Stretching that neck. Oh, again, across the chest. He's going to cave that chest in.
What's so amazing about this display by Ron Garvin Davis? Anytime now, he's waiting just for the opportunity. Yeah. Anytime he wants, he can knock him out with one punch. He knows that.
Look at a man's chest. Look how red it is. All the whelps all over it. Owens going after him. Takes Garvin. Garvin switches him. Oh, here it comes. Hands of Stone. He hasn't measured. Hard right hand right to the head. And down goes Mr. Owens. Sits on him. What a man! Trying to wake him up. He says, oh, what the heck. Your winner.
During the match, Ronnie Garvin, we were talking about this, and it's fairly obvious, anytime you want, you can knock the man out. Great display of wrestling talent up there.
Thank you, Tony. Once again, I'd like to say thank you for the cards and letters. I know I don't have much time to answer them all, but I'd like to say thank you. You know, I never realized there's so many people out there, I know this by the cards and letters, that people that don't like Ric Flair. I'd say 99% of the population. I'd hate to be walking around this world knowing that many people don't like me. But I'm going to tell you, Ric Flair, the people that like you, probably in the same category as the ones that thought Adolf Hitler was a great man. So is Charles Manson. Well, Flair, you're on my mind. You know, I've been driving a truck 4 hours a week. Does that qualify me as a truck driver? I'd say it does. You know why I'm driving a truck 4 hours a week? Because when I beat Ric Flair, I'm going to say a truck driver beat you. You see, there was one time the son of a plumber, we're talking about the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, was the world's champion. Well, a truck driver here is coming along, is going to do it. See, I'm doing it for fun. Driving a truck, I qualify as a truck driver, 18-wheeler, see? Because Ric Flair, your number is up. Very embarrassing for you to get knocked out on television. It's going to happen again, but this time it's going to be for the gold. Did you see that $35,000 worth of gold, silver, diamond, and ruby?
It's gorgeous.
What an incentive. I mean, Jim Crockett Promotion, the NWA, first class. Ric Flair, you might be first class right now, but not for long. You're looking at the man that wants to be the man, and I'm going to have to beat the man.
And we'll be back as Arn Anderson defends his world TV title against Denny Brown, and we'll talk to the world champion Ric Flair once again.
Well, as promised, we're back with the heavyweight champion of the world, Nature Boy Ric Flair, and I'm sure you've heard a comment not only of Dusty Rhodes,
Let
but of Ron Jarvis.
Let me just say one thing before I get too excited. I got a special little girl in Melrose, Minnesota, that writes me each week and wants to know what is causing all of this. In other words, to you, darling, next time you see me, I'll show you this again, too. Now, let me say one thing. Jim Crockett's Senior Memorial Cup, the grandest wrestling spectacular of all time. The Cup, Jim Crockett Senior, 50 years, the biggest promotional outfit in our great sport, as you know. They're putting together a program. The city's going to be chosen very shortly, and I'll tell the whole world right now that I'm taking my cousin, Arn Anderson, the world television champion. I'm putting him right here next to the world's heavyweight champion, and the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup is as good as ours. Money in the bank, Daddy. Woo!
Okay, that's for the heavyweight champion of the world, Nature Boy Ric Flair. Your cousin's in the ring for a match.
Yes, it's a great opportunity for the intelligent wrestling fans out there to take a look at two great athletes, the junior heavyweight champ and the world television champ, my cousin, the great Arn Anderson. Come on, Double A. Woo! You notice the difference right off the bat when Dusty Rhodes, who was unable to defend this title, had it in his possession. Was he out here week in, week out? Was he out here wrestling a man the caliber of the junior heavyweight champion of the world? I ask you, David Crockett, almighty worshiper of the American dream. Was Dusty Rhodes out here week in and week out against some of the best competition in our sport?
Yes.
David, you're lying in your teeth. You know it. You know what I'm telling you to be true? Arn Anderson has taken this title and made it exactly what it is today. In my eyes, the second most prestigious title in all of professional wrestling.
Well, you heard it from the world heavyweight champion. I have to say right now, he's got a tiger by the tail, and Denny Brown, the junior heavyweight champion, the world junior heavyweight champion. What's this man?
He's wrestling a guy that's traveled throughout the world, just like I do, defending a very prestigious title. We're talking about the junior strap.
That's
it's
correct.
A very prestigious position to have in our sport. He's a little smaller than Arn, but let me tell you, the guy was a great amateur wrestler, he's a great professional wrestler, and he represents the National Wrestling Alliance, which makes him one hell of a man for opening.
Those are the words for the heavyweight champion of the world, Nature Boy Ric Flair, David.
Well, look at Denny. He's a smart man.
Your tongue, how you talking? You're getting paid to do the commentary on this. I'm just the expert color man. Come on, let's go for the commentary.
Denny Brown, very cautious. That shows you what type of wrestler he is. He is a world-class wrestler. He's the junior heavyweight champion. He's not going to rush in on Arn Anderson. This is for the world's television title.
There's not a wrestler alive today that'll rush in on Arn Anderson, myself included. You're looking at 255 pounds, as he would say, of cultured bulk, brother. He knows where it's at all times. And Denny Brown, as great as he might be, I'm afraid is going to find out in the next 10 or 15 or 20 minutes, however long it takes, just exactly why Arn Anderson is the world television champion and why a guy like Dusty Rhodes was just wishful thinking.
Look at Denny. Good move.
You know, I like to say right here, you'd have to admit, David, a team of Arn Anderson and Ric Flair in any tag team tournament in the world has to be one of the odds-on favorites.
Odds-on favorites? Let me tell you something. I love Jimmy Cornette like a brother. And you know what I've said about Condry and Bobby Eaton, two of the greatest to ever come along in our sport. They are the world tag team champions. But gosh, let's be realistic here. If Arn and I are entered in that tournament, you're talking about two great singles champions, two world champions. I'm sure we'll be the odds on.
Right, Denny has him. Oh, almost. Arn missed the elbow. Good arm drag. Denny takes him over, hooks it. Has that arm bar. He's got to hold
Come
him down.
On,
remember, Arn Anderson has that weight advantage. He also has the time advantage. Denny has to be the aggressor.
There is Ric Flair at ringside with his cousin.
Iron comes up. Takes him over. Denny holds on. Still keeps that arm bar. Has it in tight. Holding on. And you know, you talked about the tournament. Ric Flair and Arn Anderson, very good tag team. They're going to be the world's best tag teams in that tournament.
Who's that?
In the
cup. The world's best tag team is Eaton and Condrey, the world tag team champions. You're not going to talk about those little guys that run around with scarves on their legs, mobbed by little girls in training underwear, are you? Huh? You're not going to talk about Ricky Morton and what's the other guy's name? Hoot Gibson, huh? You're not going to talk about them. You're not going to talk about Dusty Rhodes and Magnum TA, American team, are you? Huh? Come on, David. Hey, let's put the camera on the big bucks.
Rick, all I was trying to say is that next week we will tell everyone where the site for the tournament will be. The site has been selected, and we will tell them next week. I didn't want to get in an argument with you. Right now, Mr. Brown, Denny Brown, the junior heavyweight champion, has your cousin on the mat.
Let me explain something to you, David. I didn't expect anything less than a great contest. You're talking about a junior heavyweight champion.
That's right.
I'm not talking about some bum. I'm talking about a quality athlete. But as the match prevails, as the match rolls along, I'm telling you right now, Double A will have his way. You watch. You know, David, I know it's really hard for you to swallow all this because you got Magnum TA out to dinner one night and Dusty out to dinner the next night. You're at Simon Malone's with him one night. You're at Benedict's here with him. You have yet to take the world champion.
Rick, we'll be back right after this. We've got to go for a break. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're back. Denny Brown still has that arm. Arn picks him up. Denny holds on, takes him over. Still has him down. The world heavyweight champion, Ric Flair, looks on, and he is concerned because his cousin, Arn Anderson, is at a disadvantage. This is for the world's television title. The champion, Arn Anderson, the challenger, the world's junior heavyweight champion, Denny Brown. Goes up. Drops the legs across the arm. Iron's trying to get the circulation back in the arm. Denny stays on it.
Oh, David.
This is what makes this young man champion. All right, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Dusty's out there. Two of the greatest wrestling stars in the world. Your American Dream, Dusty Rhodes and Ric Flair, the world heavyweight champion. Iron catches him. Fist right in the midsection. Iron trying to get that circulation back in that arm. Dusty's shouting. Shouting encouragement to Denny Brown. Iron takes him. Puts the forearm right in the midsection. Still trying to get that arm back in shape. Can he do it? Denny's still fighting back. That's what makes a champion. Iron takes it. Stop. Knocks that wound out of him. And now takes it. Picks him out. Snapmare. Comes in. Remember, he stopped him. Knocked the wind out. Now he legs scissors. Tighter and tighter it gets.
You know, I'll tell you something. Dusty Rhodes is going to have a hard time getting out of the studio with any foul play. We came out here, you invited me out here to help commentate on a great wrestling match. I'm talking about Arn Anderson, the world champion, Denny Brown, the junior's world champion, a great contest, and Dusty Rhodes is out here stirring up trouble.
Well, Rick, you go over to the ring, right? You were out here supposed to commentate, but you've gone over to the ring. Why can't Dusty come out here and just go over to the ring?
Got 25 punk kids in here in sorority t-shirts. Obviously biased.
Denny Brown, he's fighting back, David. Oh, but he met that knee pad.
Iron, the world's television champion, picks Denny up. What's he gonna do? What's he gonna do? Drops him right across the ropes.
Right in the midsection, the top rope. Look at Flair.
Look at him. Rubbing him right across the ropes. Then he's still fighting back. The World Junior Heavyweight Champion wants that title. He wants to be the World Television Champion.
This is what we call, gentlemen, professional wrestling at its best. Two great ones.
I'll admit that.
There is no doubt they're really going after it.
Two champions, the World Junior Heavyweight Champion, the World's Television Champion. His title's on the line. He'll do just about anything to keep that championship. You see the best every week right here on World Championship Wrestling. The time is on Ironside. He has that leg scissor, holding Denny down, squeezing tighter and tighter. Can Denny hold on? He's got him down, almost. Count of two.
You know, Billy Brown has really got to be feeling the effects. You're looking at a man that can squat 650 pounds any day of the week. When you got those tree trunks wrapped around, you can imagine the pressure being exerted on Denny Brown right now.
Oh, yes.
It's a credit to Denny Brown that he's still able to continue in this match, David.
You're seeing two world-class athletes out there. The World Television Champion, Arn Anderson, the World Junior Heavyweight Champion. Almost, heads it down. Just about. Each time gets closer, count of two. What's he doing?
I think it looked like maybe he was holding onto the ropes for leverage, David.
Referee breaks it. Arn. Left hand. Then he still fights back. The young champion. He wants that title. He has the desire. Can he do it? He has Iron. Iron's dazed. He goes back. Goes down to one knee. Hard right hand again. Another missed. Iron goes down. Come on, go for the pin. He backs up. Catching him across the shoulder. He goes out on the floor.
Out on the floor. Now Dusty Rhodes walks around where he is. Ric Flair's there. There's Dusty.
And Ric Flair comes over here.
That's just a classic example of why Arn Anderson is a world champion. He knows where he is in that ring at all times. He got himself in a bit of a predicament, but got Denny Brown out of the ring just like that. That's what you call ring savvy, my friend. That's what you call knowing your trade.
Look at Denny. He comes right back. He goes over. Has him. Just about. Arn catches him right on the top of the head.
Pull over 255 pounds a man. Sometimes that's easier said than done.
Denny's still fighting. Both men. Here he goes, cross. He's going to do a kick. Denny kicks him. Iron's down. Both men gasping for air. Here he goes, cross. Comes up, backdrop. Almost. Forearm.
The times like this that I'm so proud to be a member of Jim Crockett Forces and the National Wrestling Alliance, because this is what professional wrestling is all about.
Heads him down for the pin, almost.
Denny Brown is.
Great athletes competing at the highest level possible. This is professional wrestling.
That it is. The very best right here. Heads him up. Gourdbuster put the face right in the mat.
The Gourdbuster puts out Denny Brown and Arn Anderson wins.
Wait a minute, Dusty Rhodes comes in.
What a battle.
Wait a minute, look at this. Dusty Rhodes, tag of TA, Ric Flair, Arn Anderson. Do we have it? Do we have another match? Rick, do we have another match? Come on,
you know,
they want you in there.
David, let me say something to you. It's just like Rhodes and Magnum TA to want a man to slip out of about $15,000 worth of goods and get in the ring, and they want a man that's just competed against a world champion and beat him right in the middle of the ring.
time I'm in the building, or my cousin Ric Flair's in the building, it just makes me want to show out a little bit. He always told me, he said, you know, I've been a champion all my life. If you want to run with me, if you want to uphold a family name, it's real simple. All you got to do is beat the cream of the crop in the middle where there's no argument, no belly aching, and become a world champion. And Tony Giovanni, I've done like I said I would. Week after week, I did exactly what Dusty Rhodes wouldn't do. Come on national television and defend it in front of top competitors in the world today. So I don't want to hear any garbage out of you, or any of these goofs out here, because I've earned it. I am the world television champion. And in the words of my famous cousin, Ric Flair, whether you like it or not, there ain't nothing you can do about it. That includes you, Dusty Rhodes.
You know, Tony, it's got to be real difficult for anybody, any of our peers, so to speak, in the wrestling world, to stand before us when we're loaded with our armor. Both of these say the one thing, world champion. Second. Both of us, world champion in our own right. Rick. We're going to be teamed up in that Jim Crockett Sr.
Rick, one minute. Go ahead, Tony.
Let's talk about some of the peers. One of your peers, obviously, Ron Garvin. And we'd like to take a look at a film clip right here, a match you and Ron Garvin.
Why are you
60-minute,
Ron Garvin?
60-minute time limit draw.
Ron Garvin,
and you call Ron Garvin back into the ring. Here's what happens.
What are you trying to bring this on TV for? Huh? Where did you get this film?
This film provided, of course, Jim Crockett Promotions, Tommy Young, the referee.
More collusion, Tony Giovanni. Lopsided commentation. As you see, where's Ronnie Garvin? Flat of his can, gasping Flair. Does Ric Flair, is his derby bulging? No, it's not. Is he breathing hard? No, it's not. Ronnie Garvin, I think I heard him say it once or twice, I quit. No fights. No intestinal fortitude, and the world champion is eating his lunch.
This is propaganda right here. I know exactly what they're doing.
Sure it is.
This is propaganda.
Well,
hey, you keep your mouth shut, or you'll be out of the studio,
toe
buddy.
To toe. Right there.
Tony Schiavone, just one question. Is a closed fist illegal or not? Yes or no? Yes or no?
Okay, it is.
That's the man is
move.
Down.
It's just like hitting the man
the
in the head
got
with a ball
knocked out.
Number. It's illegal, David Crockett.
The world heavyweight champion, Ric Flair, you were knocked out by Ron Garvin.
The biggest fluke I've ever seen or ever heard of in my entire life. Couldn't happen again in a million years.
Okay, now, like we said, after the match was over, 60-minute draw, called him back to the ring, and that's what happened.
You know, it never ceases to amaze me. I'm standing out here with Arn Anderson, the world television champion. I'm standing out here so custom made. The designer magazines all over the country are looking for me, and you never stopped trying to assault me. Well, Garvin, that was after the 60 minutes was over, and that referee had no right counting 1, 2, 3. And the bottom line is, Garvin, if you keep messing around with me, the same thing's going to happen to you that happened to Dusty Rhodes, and you pass that along.
World champions Arn Anderson.
Pass that along on a very serious note.
Arn Anderson, the world TV champion, and Ric Flair. David, we needed to show that.
That's right, we had.
He was talking about his peers, and Ron Garvin, one of his peers, knocked him out. We'll be right back. For the first time ever, the National Wrestling Alliance has sanctioned a one-night tag team tournament. And the winner of that tag team tournament will receive, and we're very proud to announce this, the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. Also, a purse of $1 million has been added to this one-night tournament. And we have some very special news about the tournament, David.
That's correct. Next week, we're going to tell you where the tournament will be. The site has already been chosen, but next week, they'll give us permission to tell you exactly where that tournament will be.
And as you know, bids have come in from all over the world, all over the country, hoping to be the home of this inaugural tournament. We're going to find out next week, let you fans know where the tournament will be held. Let's go to the ring.
In the ring, the Monster, the Barbarian against Kent Glover. Paul Jones again. He has some awesome men.
Some awesome men he could put in that tournament.
That's right. You look at the Barbarian. You saw Tejo Khan, Baron Von Raschke, Paul Jones. David. A man that can control these
yeah.
men.
No one else can.
Referees have tried. Other wrestlers have tried. David, before the match really gets going here, we'd like to wish Bob and Carol White of Roanoke, Virginia, happy 51st anniversary. And they tell me that tonight they're going to celebrate their anniversary by going to the matches.
Great.
Right to us. World Championship Wrestling, 1250 South Omni International, Atlanta 30303. We'd love to hear from you of anniversary announcements of 50 years or more. Also, Tony, they can use that address to write to their favorite wrestler. And we'd like to hear, too, any of your comments about World Championship Wrestling. And, David, while we're on this note, a lot of fans in the letters we got this week wanted to know how to come to the studios, and we'll be talking about the phone number in just a second that you see right there. But
look at me. Yeah, but you see the phone number. Look at the Barbarian. Look at this monster.
The TV reservation number right there. But I tell you what, one armed the man down.
He's huge. Look at him. Glover now. Here's a headlock. He's going. Is he going to keep the Barbarian down? Is he going to keep this monster down? No, it won't. Look at him. Just stands there. Glover trying to figure out. He comes in on him again. Barbarian puts a shoulder into him. Puts a foot right in his face. Watch him now. Is he going to press him? Yes, he has him up. Drops him right on his back.
Kent Glover is such a big man, too. And it almost seemed effortless that time when the Barbarian picked him up.
Headbutt. Headbutt again.
Claiming to be the strongest man in wrestling, Ron Bass says, by golly, I'll take him on.
But this Barbarian, he's something. Slams him. Is he going to do it? Tony, he looks around. The Barbarian goes over. Now watch this man fly. And he literally flies all the way across the ring. There he goes. Headbutt. And the Glover rolls him over. Has him down for the pin.
This time when the Barbarian connects, he actually pushes a man across the ring with that flying headbutt. Yeah! Excitement Plus here on World Championship Wrestling. We got some members of Kappa Sig fraternity at Mercer University here with us today in Macon, Georgia. And some other great fans here with us. And here is Jim Cornette. I understand.
To talk about Tony. David, why don't you back up? You're not being very useful. First of all, I heard the Road Warriors out here going out talking about a World Tag Team title match. Well, let me tell you something. I think the best thing maybe for you to do is have Paul call my mother, because we are busy. We do have a tight schedule. Maybe we can work in sometime before December. Now, secondly, the big Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup coming up. Tag Team Tournament, the first international tag team tournament that's truly international in the history of professional wrestling, and $1 million on the line. I don't see why they just don't go ahead and give us the cup and give us the million and save everybody the trouble of getting in the ring and getting humiliated, because we've already proven that we're the best team in wrestling, the NWA World Tag Team Champions. Is that right, Tony?
You're the champions
exactly
right now.
That's exactly right. So just give us the cup, give us the money. We'll save everybody a lot of trouble. Now, the Rock and Roll Express, they come out here talking about justice. They come out here talking about how they got cheated. They come out here talking about all the agony and pain they've suffered. Well, let me tell you something. The plain fact of the matter is, the one thing wrong with the Rock and Roll Express is they are habitual, chronic losers. They have no ability compared to the Midnight Express. They have no guts compared to the Midnight Express. They have no brains compared to yours truly. They might be able to beat and take advantage of all the other managers and all the other teams of professional wrestling, but they can't top us. That's why they come up with excuses of why they lost their belts. The only thing they had that set them apart from everybody else, and we took them away, and now they come up with this deal in conjunction with Dusty Rhodes talking about trying to put me in a cage. I am not a criminal. I'm not a pickpocket. I'm not a gorilla or a parakeet, and I shouldn't be in a cage. Shut up. I heard that. Believe me, I heard that. I shouldn't be in any kind of cage. I have documents right here. A note from my mother's physician saying that I have a morbid fear of heights. I have letters from all of my, you can see them all later. Letters from all of my fans saying that I should not be put in a cage. And I don't see why that they persist in trying to do something like this and saying that I interfere when I never interfere. I never cheat. The Midnight Express win fairly and squarely. I will find some way to have mother's lawyers get an injunction against this. You will not see me in a cage, much less 150 feet or however far they're going to hoist it up over the ring. I refuse to take part in anything like that, Tony. Well, I'm upset. Wouldn't you be upset? I got documents right here. I got proof. I have a fear of heights, and I have a lot of fans that don't want to see me in a cage. And ladies and gentlemen, once again, I present the greatest team in wrestling, the NWA World Tag Team Champions, Loverboy Dennis and beautiful Bobby the Midnight Express.
Better word is scared in my life. He is really concerned right now. He does not have a pleasant look on his face at all.
While the Midnight Express is whipping up on these two geeks, I just want to make one more point. Talking about the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup, this will define the greatest tag team in professional wrestling because every team that's anybody's going to be entered, and there's a lot of prize money at stake. I heard Nature Boy Ric Flair say something, and with all due respect to Mr. Flair as the greatest single professional athlete walking the face of the earth today, and with all due respect to Arn Anderson as a world champion in his own right and a close personal friend, two great individuals do not always make a great tag team. A tag team is defined by the practice of two men who work better together in a wrestling ring than any other force combined in professional wrestling. And the Midnight Express are the definition of the word tag team. Two great individuals cannot always blend together as such a team. I just want you to watch it. Give him a suplex, Bobby, right there. Beautiful. He can do anything in that ring. And Loverboy Dennis, he can do anything too. And together, they are the greatest combination ever in sports. They are the definition of the word tag team. Something to think about. You know, $1 million up. I'd like to see what America's team and the Rock and Roll Express, I'd like to see how great their friendship was with $1 million at stake. $1 million make a lot of people. You can stab David Crockett in the back for $1 million, Tony Schiavone, and you do it in a twinkling of an eye.
I wouldn't hit him with a tennis racket. Oh, that time, Mike Schiavone.
What's he going to do now? Look at Cornette. When a man's down, he's at his best.
Oh, now Bobby's
wait a minute,
up.
Wait a minute.
Bobby's up on the top.
Look out. Good grief.
Well, that time Bobby
likes to make sure I'm not in the way of anything. He doesn't want me to get hurt. That's part of the contract.
I wonder what he's going to do when Mr. Cornette's in that cage. We won't have to worry about Mr. Cornette being hurt when he's in a cage.
Bringing up things like that, David Carl, you'd love to see a cage snap, wouldn't you? You'd love to see me 80 feet in the ring, see a cable grab, see me hurtle down to the ring, and probably land on Dennis and Bobby as well, and get rid of all three of us. You'd love it, wouldn't you?
I didn't think about that, but that's not it.
Well, I'm going to have somebody watching the trigger on that daggum thing. I promise you that if it comes about. And I don't think it's going to, because I'm going to find some way to weasel, I mean, to get, to change the contract.
He's even getting tongue-tied.
I think so. But nothing's wrong with this team in the ring, because they're as awesome as ever, David.
That they are. Lover boy Dennis, Full Nelson, what's he going to do now? Oh, no! He took his face. The man could not defend himself at all, held his arms behind him, and pushed his face right through that mat. Oh. Here they come! What do they have? Tennis rackets! Oh, boy! These guys, rock and roll, look at them! They just cleared the ring. Rock and roll is here to stay.
With tennis rackets! Back at World Championship Wrestling, if our calculations are right, I guess it's down to 2 weeks now, wouldn't it be?
Well, you've been paying attention, and that really impresses me. But looking, putting that aside for just a second, there's been a lot of rhetoric today about the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup, the big tag team tournament coming up. $1 million added purse to the winners. And, of course, we have already set our goal on the national heavyweight title. We've set a time limit. We're down to the last 2 weeks. When you're talking about $1 million, the four horsemen got together. We were talking about the situation. Mr. Blanchard was in agreement that Nature Boy Ric Flair, the world heavyweight champion, Arn Anderson, the world television champion, should get the green light to get in the gym, start training as a tag team combination. Hey, $1 million. We're setting our immediate goals, of course, on the national heavyweight title. 2 weeks left. I don't know where, I don't know when, but it's fact
that's
going to happen.
Whenever he wants to sign a contract, that's the bottom line.
And once we take the national heavyweight title, see, the other thing you have to look at in this tournament is the people that have the more prestigious titles, even as in a tag team tournament, are going to be in a better position as far as the seedings. And the more stronger you are, this is a whole lot better situation. I'd rather go into a tournament knowing I only have to wrestle once to come out with $1 million, knowing that I have to go through three or four tag team combinations. And as a national heavyweight champion, even in a tag team tournament, regardless of who we would take, Mr. Blanchard, as a tag team partner. And I really was impressed with my old friend Jimmy Garvin when I saw him today. The fans didn't get to see what he had to offer, but I know what he has to offer. The national heavyweight champion, Jimmy Garvin, going for $1 million. The world heavyweight champion, Arn Anderson, the same tournament. And the who's who of professional wrestling. The potential of this tournament is mind-boggling. And you better believe the four horsemen, no matter what the combinations, are going to be right in the thick of it. And Dusty Rhodes, no more national title. He's going to be history.
Tully Blanchard Enterprises, James J. Dillon, Tully Blanchard, let's go to the ring. The Rock and Roll Express, the tag team of the 80s. There it is. Thunderfoot and Blackmar. And coming in with their tennis rackets, we should say. Don't go anywhere without them.
That is right. Look at Ricky Morton. Switched out. Catches Thunderfoot. Now he catches Bart again. And Thunderfoot. They are ready. And I tell you, Tony, one thing that makes these men go, the Rock and Roll Express, are you fans. You pump them up, you keep them up there, and you keep them going. When they're down, you pick them up. And listen to the fans now. We've got great fans here. Matter of fact, we have the RAs from Telmo Baptist Church. They're here in the studio. Watch. They cheer them on. Good drop. Catch the next one.
He can do it. Ricky Morton can do it.
Much bigger men in this case, too, but I mean the Rock and Roll can overcome all odds.
Robert Gibson's in there. Bart has him. Switch now by Gibson. Drives Bart in the tongue. Picks him up. Hard right hand. Makes the tag to Ricky Morton. Into the ropes. Tackle. Bart's got it. All right across the rope.
Oh, a great move by Bart. Using the momentum of that time of Morton.
Put him right in the side. Now double team.
Double clothesline that time as Thunderfoot's in. Tell you what, this team of Thunderfoot and Bart's a good team.
Yes, they are.
They could be a threat to the World Tag Team Championship.
Look at him. Bart has him. Backs up. What's he going to do? Shoulder breaker.
Right now, Ricky Morton's in trouble.
They have this team with the Rock and Roll Express at a disadvantage.
Oh, double backdrop.
Good teamwork by Black Bart and Thunderfoot. Bart makes that tag. Thunderfoot. Ricky trying to fight back. Makes the tag to Gibson. Gibson comes in. Takes both men on. Headbutt. Takes Thunderfoot. Whips him in. Sleeper. He has it locked. Bart comes over. Catches him. Ricky comes in now. Takes on Bart. All four men in the ring. Bart goes over. What's he going to do? Oh. Tried the up. Look at. He's got a double drop kick.
They got him down. They got him.
That is it. Bart tried the clothesline. Ricky ducked. Bart went over the ropes. Thunderfoot was trying to load his boot. Double drop kick by the Rock and Roll Express.
This is where the action is. The Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors.
Hey, Tony Schiavone, let me say one thing. Paul Jones, where do you get off even using our name in the same interview? We'll take any two or all three of the goons in your so-called army and slap their faces like girls. You know, within the next 2 days, my brother Hawk and I are going to be in our great hometown of Chicago, and then the next day, all the way out to East Rutherford, New Jersey, in the Meadowlands, and the Koloffs. We're going to beat you up so bad in the Meadowlands, you're going to want to go back to Russia with your tail between your stinking legs.
You know, Russian athletes, they've always had everything given to them on a silver platter. You're an athlete over there, and you're big time. Well, we worked for what we got. We started out street fighting, then we went to bouncing bars, back to street fighting, then into professional wrestling. And I'll tell you something, once in a while, we still get back to Chicago to clean up the neighborhood. I'll tell you something, New York, get rid of you neo-Mexi-Zoom dweebies, because we're coming your way.
That's right, and Russians, watch out for those double chain matches. They're right up our alley.
All right, the Legion of Doom with Precious Paul Ellering, Magnum T.A., the Russian team, and much more yet to come. Ivan and Nikita Koloff, two-thirds of the world's six-man tag team champions. Ivan, one thing I'd like to ask you. Last week, Nikita was talking to you. It obviously was in Russian that we couldn't understand. Could you tell us exactly what you were talking about?
Hey, American, that is none of you. None of your business. That is for the Kremlin, nephew Nikita, and myself to know. Now, everybody know worldwide the Jim Crockett promotion, most successful, biggest promoter last 50 years. That is why our contracts are going to be in order for Jim Crockett Memorial Cup Tag Team Tournament. And you Road Warriors, you come out here shooting your big mouth off, saying how you're going to run us out of the country, back to the Soviet Union. You should be more concerned about double chain matches in Michigan, in Canton, in Wheeling, or six men tag team competition in Meadowlands along with this American dream, Dusty Rhodes. And you, Magnum T.A., you take a look at Nephew Nikita with his whole new attitude glasses. Yes, simply because of this Magnum T.A., showing that he is afraid of Nephew Nikita, that he is nothing but coward. Because ever since I come out here and tell everybody Nikita not wrestle anymore on television until that coward Magnum T.A. signed a contract putting the United States heavyweight title on television against Nephew Nikita, he has been avoiding us. No contract, no rebuttal, nothing. This Magnum T.A. is obviously afraid of the Kolar family.
About that, but you know, he is the U.S. heavyweight champion, he defends the title.
How could
but
you
he
call
is in the
him
ring.
United States heavyweight champion?
Let's
he
go to the ring.
Sign contract against him. Yes, let's see this Magnum T.A. See how great he is
in the ring. Bill Tabb against the United States heavyweight champion Magnum T.A.
defeat on television.
Quickest pin on TV held by Magnum T.A. That's right, it's a record. Glenn up against Big Bill Tabb.
Goes down. Good drop kick by the United States heavyweight champion, Magnum T.A.
Stay
on the belly! You heard him! This is for Nikita! And
okay.
That's it!
He could not do this to Nephew Nikita. There is no way.
He's not avoiding you at all now. He has challenged him to come to the ring right now.
Both men, Nikita Koloff and Magnum T.A. How can you control it?
Oh, the wrestlers coming in now.
Everybody. I mean, all the wrestlers are in there trying to pull these two men apart. United States heavyweight champion Magnum T.A. and Nikita Koloff.
Here comes Dusty. They can't pull them apart.
They're trying. They've got him. They've got him. No. Well, they almost had him. Look at him.
My goodness, they still can't pull the U.S. champion, Magnum T.A. And Nikita Koloff apart. Okay, they got him apart now.
They got him apart.
And they're right over close to us. Oh, what a day it's been on World Championship Wrestling. We're
right here in the program. Well, we almost had it. Magnum goes right after. Magnum, TA United States Heavyweight Champion. It's after Nikita. He won't
let go. We got to go.
See you next week.
See you next week.